Hi, freaks. It's Wednesday, February 22nd, 2023. Coming up on the program today, the urine wizard casts a few piss spells on us. Plus, when the groom breastfeeds before walking down the aisle, and evil Elmo is back and he's brought a friend, anti-Semitic Cookie Monster. All this coming up today. Distorted View Daily proudly presents Great Moments in Geriatric Fetish Porn.
I'm so tired.
You're tired?
Yes.
Why don't you just sit down right here and just rest for a little bit? How does that, Mrs. McGuire?
Thank you.
Let me see if I can call those orderlies and see if I can get them here to orient you. I'll be right back.
Mrs. McGuire.
Oh.
Hi, Mrs. McGuire.
Hey.
How you doing today?
Oh, I'm not feeling too good. I'm really tired.
Well, I understand that. That's normal. And we're your orderlies.
Oh.
We're here to give you some orientation.
Yeah.
Because this is the first time you've been here at Retirement Meadows, isn't it?
I'm really confused. Don't they have any shuffleboard here?
Oh, no. We don't have shuffleboard here.
Well, what about bingo night?
Why, we don't have any bingo either.
So what's an old lady like me supposed to do in retirement center?
Well, how about sucking our cocks?
I haven't sucked a cock in 20 years!
Well, welcome to your golden years, baby. Come on.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's it. Fuck me, you little whippersnappers.
It's the Distorted View Show with Tim Henson.
Well, I really like shortbread.
Full bloom AIDS.
SMH. I think that means shaking my head.
Push F on my Twitter sheet.
She is a fat cunt.
All right, hey freaks, Tim back here. Finally returning for your Wednesday podcast. Hope you enjoyed the best of show I posted a little bit earlier today. I've just been so busy with my game development, I lost track of time. You know, I'm working on Galileo's Adventure, an 8-bit side-scroller. I just completed 3 more levels, including another boss battle. So you may remember, I don't know if you guys played it, I put a little demo up over there at distortedview.com. The first big boss at the end of level 3 was Mead Skelton.
Yeah.
After beating him, you then move on to the Ice Worlds, where at the end of level 6, you must battle Alexis K. Tyler. She is literally a pussy pilot. She's buzzing around the screen in her little pussy plane. She's also trying to drop dildo missiles on you, and you have to throw your baby and hit her 3 or 4 times before she dies. I'll work on exporting a new build and, posting it on the website so you can play those new levels as well. I'm sure you're all dying to experience Galileo's Adventure. By the way, that's not the real reason why this show was posted late. I don't want you guys to think I'm ignoring DV duties to dick around with a game. Those levels have been made for a while now. I just haven't talked about it here on the podcast.
I'm a game developer now.
At the top of the show, I got to mention something. A couple of freaks have sent me a link to a TikTok account. Yeah, we got a new TikTok here. This is the Free Money Project. I'm interested. Who doesn't want free money? I'll do whatever this guy says for some cash.
Thanks for watching. Yesterday, I had a few sips of my own urine, and it was like a magic potion. And today, I actually feel like a wizard.
I'm sorry. What? I was under the impression there was going to be free money involved. Maybe his rationale is like, you don't have to go spending your money on drinks anymore. Your body produces the most delicious beverage, urine.
Had a few sips of my own urine.
Why are pee drinkers so weird? I mean, by their very nature, dude, drinking your own piss is not a normal thing. So yes, they're going to be a little weird, but he even has to pronounce urine in a strange way. I do have to mention the very first comment I saw on this video. he calls himself a piss wizard here. The commenter says Harry Pisser and the Philosopher's Kidney Stone, which I thought was kind of funny. Still, you can't deny that the account is called Free Money Project. Maybe piss drinking is just a hobby of his, but the main focus of the TikTok channel is unlocking all of our potential for wealth. So let's watch another video from Free Money Project.
I woke up this morning and did a wee into this special cup. Had a sip. It didn't taste quite right for the spell I wanted. So I just intuitively had some water, some black coffee, and some beef broth. And then I did another wee into the cup. And I just had a little sip because I can taste if the spell's right or not.
I've heard of black magic. I've heard of white magic. I've never heard of yellow magic.
Oh, yeah. That was good. That was very good. So at that point, I had a rescue remedy lolly. And I thanked the potion with the magic words. And then here came the idea. So I'm going to put $450 down later. I've put it on here. There's a little note. Some happy money for you. Enjoy.
Wait a second. Is the Free Money Project piss propaganda? Trying to lure unsuspecting people into that pee-drinking lifestyle? He's a urine groomer. You know, I bet you he acts all friendly to people, handing out $50 bills and stuff. And when they start talking to him, he nonchalantly mentions the reason he's able to give out all this money is because he's a pee wizard using yellow magic. And you too could be flush with cash. Excuse the pun there, flush.
And on the back, I've put my TikTok name.
Yep.
So maybe someone will
there it is.
Get in touch and say they found some happy money. So it's very fun and exciting, and I'm loving every minute of it. It's happy day.
This guy is so jolly.
It's happy money. It's thank you so much for watching to the end. Thank you.
Now, when it comes to these types of content creators, you can never be sure they're 100% sincere. He might not actually be drinking urine. This could all be for views. Although freaks have sent in videos where he's like in his house, and like the condition of his home certainly points to piss drinker. Like, it's a fucking wreck in his kitchen. All the cabinet doors have been ripped off or removed. It's a mess. It's disgusting. Utterly filthy, except for the bowl of fresh fruit in the middle of the counter. Something interesting did happen with the piss wizard in the last few days. He acknowledged that he was drinking a lot more urine than normal. And he thought he might have a problem, like an alcoholic. So I don't know if he's attempting dry February or he's, you know, just trying to go a week or two without drinking pee. But this is day four.
Well, this is day four of me not drinking my own urine. And my mind's starting to play tricks on me.
It's telling me to do things I normally wouldn't do. Today I killed a 7-Eleven employee.
It started out with a little sip and then I went to about a pint every day, two pints at the weekend, and, you know, on a big night, three pints of my own urine.
It's getting out of control. A real urine addiction.
So that's why I just want to keep it under control for a bit, have a break. So this is day four. So I'm hanging in there.
Look, you can't do it alone. We all think we can. I highly suggest you check into rehab.
When life gives you lemons, make wee-monade.
I think he's off the wagon. Well, there you go. That's the Piss Wizard on TikTok. It's a much better username than the Free Money Project. Let's move on. A recent U-tard find is back. You may recall the obviously mentally ill man who was walking around Walmart accusing everyone of not being real, of either being bots or soulless NPCs. And because these people aren't real in his own little fruity mind, he can be as mean as he wants to them. Well, today he went back to Walmart. I'm guessing this is a different Walmart, one that he hasn't yet been banned from. You know how sometimes if you go to Walmart and you're leaving, there's like two sets of sliding doors, right? You go through the sliding door and then there's like vending machines and shopping carts and stuff. And then you go through the final set of doors to reach freedom. Well, in the area by the shopping carts and the vending machines, occasionally there will be like organizations, like Girl Scouts selling cookies. That's where the Salvation Army people ring their goddamn bells. Well, today there is a suicide prevention nonprofit, and our YouTuber friend here had to confront them. Now, the first thing that's going to happen is you're going to hear some racket.
They don't have a winnable fucking argument with this dumb
soul. Right there. He's breaking through the little gates that say emergency only. You are not supposed to leave this way.
So, I'm about to take a video. Oh my God, Shaka Zulu, what are you looking at? You're creeping me out, Shaka Zulu.
Even though he himself is black, he just has to be racist to the fat black woman who's just doing her job. And that's when he sees the suicide prevention booth.
Hey, soulless reject. If you shouldn't kill yourself, why can't you control your emotions? If you shouldn't kill yourself, explain why you can't control your emotions. If you shouldn't kill yourself, why do other adults have to worry about your emotions? Explain. You always know you should kill yourself when you're an adult over 12 and you can't handle your emotions.
Hello,
what?
What's going on?
Oh, yeah, I'm making a video at the grassroots for losers too weak-minded to go kill themselves and think they can burden the rest of the world like a baby.
Yeah, the rest of the video is just Walmart employees trying to get this guy to stop recording and leave their store. That's okay, there are a lot of Walmarts, and our protagonist here likes to hit them all. It just so happens the next Walmart he went to, there was also a nonprofit organization with a booth. This one's just trying to keep hungry kids from dying. Not surprisingly, our friend here has a problem with them as well.
If kids are being born as losers who can't earn, then they're going to be hungry.
He has a point, right?
Are you just lowlifes trying to pretend to do something good? Like a snake under the grass?
This confrontation goes on for 6 minutes, and at no point does he ever get punched in the fucking face. It's really the most infuriating part of his YouTube channel. Like, he never suffers any consequences for going after people. In one video, it's like 20 seconds long. I'll play it for you here. He sees a black man and his Hispanic girlfriend.
Whoa, you got ugly. Well, you got ugly Hispanic thing.
Yeah.
What are you going to do? Shoot me because you can't shoot up talking English, right?
And that's it. He doesn't run away or anything. He just continues pushing his cart, shopping in Walmart, suffers no consequences. He's calling women ugly, calling Walmart employees Shaka Zulus. Other people, monkeys. I don't know how this dude is alive. My only theory is that he must just look mentally ill and people are pitying him. All of his videos are like first person, right, point of view. So you never really see the dude.
You always know you're less than a person because everything you do only helps you and you can't think about it.
You're talking to volunteers for an organization that is trying to feed hungry kids. Your argument doesn't quite work here.
Yeah, you're a worthless monkey. You're a monkey you're a worthless monkey. I don't respect you. I would never respect you. You're a worthless monkey. So why are you talking to me, worthless monkey?
Why are you recording?
Yeah, so I can make fun of you and how dumb your thought process is.
So whenever you're done.
This is being honest.
Of course.
I'm recording you so I can mock you.
God defeated evil with the subconscious. All you have to do is fill in a broken logic, and you're going to do what Judas and Robin Williams did, beast. You soulless beast. I'm not touching you, so you can't do anything.
And you know what? They didn't do anything to him. I'm kind of jealous. You know, I admire the fact that this guy can just say whatever he wants to people in public and suffer no consequences. Hey, monkey, you soulless bitch. You should kill yourself. And not a peep out of the people he's talking to. They're just like, all right, I'll take that into consideration. Thank you. Great shit as always from him. Moving on now, I have got an online court case involving child support. This guy was a little behind, a lot behind. Rather than face a court case, though, it looks like they came up with an agreement. All he has to do is plead guilty and then catch up with his payments in a year. Pretty standard stuff, but this guy, he doesn't want to go to trial, but he also doesn't want to admit to doing anything wrong. He's incapable of that. So he has a real problem saying that he pleads guilty.
That is the plea you're taking this morning, correct?
This is his attorney speaking.
Yes.
Thank you. We can't see you anymore, Mr. Johnson.
Oh, yeah. Mr. Johnson is zooming in from his bedroom. He's literally lying on his bed, Half the time, the camera is positioned so you just see up his nostrils. Sometimes you just get a view of his double chins. Other times, it's completely black.
You swear or affirm to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth under penalty of perjury?
I suppose.
I need a yes or a no.
Long pause. Think about it.
Yes.
There we go.
Is it your intention to plead guilty today?
Yes, I accept the plea.
That's the closest we're going to get to him saying guilty. And at first, the judge is like, okay with this, but eventually he wants to hear the words come out of his mouth.
If a guilty plea is accepted, there'll be no trial. That means you're giving up the rights that you would have had at trial. I'm going to explain those rights to you now to make sure that you understand them. You do have the right to a speedy trial.
I'm starting to think he's just drunk.
Mr. Johnson, if you're going to interrupt me, I'm going to hold you in contempt.
I'm sorry.
It's just hilarious what you're saying. Like a comedy routine. Here's where the real problem starts.
How do you wish to plead to the charge that on or about September 1st, 2018 through September 30, 2019, in the city of Adrian County of Lenawee, that you did commit the offense of failing to pay child support?
I accept the plea.
If you want to plead guilty, you need to say guilty.
He's going to make you say that motherfucking word.
Do you want me to say guilty? Okay, fine.
Still didn't say it.
If you want to plead guilty to this offense, then you need to say that you plead guilty.
How about I spell the word?
I accept the plea.
That's not
Mr. Johnson.
That's not a guilty plea. So if that's all you're going to say, Mr. Johnson, then I'm going to continue your not guilty plea and we'll proceed to trial on January 25th.
I never entered a not guilty plea.
Well, you didn't enter a guilty plea either. You refused to say the word.
Mr. Johnson.
The issue here.
There are two pleas available, guilty or not guilty. Which do you choose today?
This is attorney trying to help him.
Guilty or not guilty?
The first one.
They want the not guilty or the guilty, so that's
well,
fine.
No, Mr. Johnson, it's a matter of what you want to do today. Do you want to plead guilty or not guilty?
No, it doesn't matter what I want to do.
I want to go to sleep.
Mr. Johnson?
I think maybe he did fall asleep.
Are you going to plead guilty today or not?
Yes, that's acceptable.
You got to say the words.
If you want to plead guilty, you need to say that you're pleading guilty. That. Your audio was not clear. What did you just say?
Yes.
All right. This is the last time I'm going to explain this to you. And otherwise, we're just going to leave the trial set. How do you wish to plead to the charge that you failed to pay child support?
The judge is looking for one word and one word only. What do you think Gregory here is going to say? I accept the plea.
Well, you determined that I was guilty, so yes, I am guilty.
There we go.
Sir, the elements of the crime are you...
at least he said the word guilty.
...ordered to pay child support, and you failed to pay for whatever
my
reason.
My income did not support that.
That the doesn't matter. That doesn't matter.
Well, he found me guilty, so that's what
he didn't
is.
Find you guilty. He's asking, were you ordered to pay child support, and did you fail to pay it? It's either yes or no. If it's a yes, then you plead guilty.
My income did not support the child support.
Judge, let's just leave it on for trial.
No, I want the deal.
Then you need to admit what you did.
Yeah, he cannot admit any wrongdoing whatsoever. He can't say the word guilty. He can't admit to not paying child support. You know, it's just a bunch of excuses. His lawyer tries to explain to him what's going on. I'm going to fast forward that part because it's a lot of her talking.
Now, did you pay that child support or not? If you did not, then you need to say
I was
the word
unable.
Guilty.
No, I did not. Okay.
There. Whew.
So is that a guilty?
We're not going further with this. The record is already.
Yeah, the judge has had enough.
Not satisfactory.
I'm guilty of the circumstances that set this thing.
That's still not just guilty. Just say guilty and that's it.
Mr. Johnson has not indicated.
Yes, guilty.
He had such a hard time with that word for the entire clip until the very end here. Now he can't shut up. Guilty.
I plead guilty.
I've made my decision for today.
Do you want to set a time for January 23rd, Judge?
I plead guilty today.
You're too late, my dude.
Mr. Johnson, I've already explained to you that you have behaved today in a way that I am not going to accept a guilty plea.
That ship has sailed, asshole.
To enter that plea. And if you show up and you answer the question,
do it.
Mr. Johnson, I've said it. This is the last time I'm saying it for you. If you interrupt me one more time, I'm going to hold you in contempt and sentence you to 30 days in the Lenawee County Jail.
It appears that at some point this guy came to. I don't know if he's just completely out of his mind drunk or something, but he sobered up. He went through his lawyer, entered a guilty plea. It was accepted. And that's why there is no further court trial, in case you're wondering what happened with this guy. Quite frankly, I think Zoom court hearings were the best thing to come out of this whole COVID-19 bullshit. Love watching those things. Moving on, Great Big Pete sent in a clip for Black History Month, so you know it's going to be super racist. I can already tell there's going to be a problem because there is an interracial couple just standing on the street corner, I guess waiting to cross the road. Someone happens to be filming them. Let's see what goes down here.
You guys know race mixing was illegal up until 2000. Race mixing was illegal up until 2002.
Until 2002? This filmed in Alabama or something?
No, you realize that race mixing, it's going to give up 50,000 years of your evolution, right? There's 2 billion of those people being born because of...
Did you know that it's actually better evolutionary to, like...
No, it's not.
I'm not going to talk science.
No, it's not.
I'm a scientist. No, it's not. I'm not going to talk about this.
Literally,
well, they all sound like idiots. Literally. I also don't believe she's a scientist. And where did this 50,000 year number come from?
Literally, you're just throwing down your genetic line.
Good. Who the fuck cares about genetic lines?
Pretty much, you're just LARPing. You're LARPing as a European in America. If you had any actual, like, heart and integrity,
hey, homie, are you done?
What are you, a Jew?
Are you done?
Are you Jewish?
Fuck no,
I ain't no Jew. This is the person who is coming to the interracial couple's defense. Hey, man, it's still the South. I think we're making progress here. We got a white guy defending an interracial couple. It's okay that he's a little anti-Semitic.
Stop that shit.
What are you, some SJW warrior?
Dude, I don't give a fuck.
Hey,
it's done.
White people are only 7% of the world's population.
I'm part of that. And it's done now.
And if we
If
we intermix, we're going to become...
Who gives a fuck, dude?
I give a fuck because we're the only...
That's kind of my argument, too. Who gives a fuck? I need some color in my skin. I wish I was a little black.
No, we're not. No, we ain't.
Net migration only flows into white country. No, it doesn't flow into...
Just stop.
Exactly.
Stop. He's stupid.
Hey, name me one black country that you would want to move to.
I hear the Togolese Republic is beautiful this time of year. I don't know if I'd make it my primary residence, but, you know, I'd consider a vacation home there.
Name me one black or brown country that you would move to. Everybody moves into white countries. Everyone moves into white countries for a reason. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Because you don't have a retort.
And that is the state of race relations here in the United States. Again, happy Black History Month. Finally, Haley's Comet submitted a Linda Finkel Hall of Fame nominee of sorts. He wrote, "Pan Panascore, our monkey overlord, may have a groupie here." Yes, this song is from Yelena Rapp and is called Chimp Simp, Monkey Sexual.
I've been wishing for a simian boo. Gotta keep me on a leash when I visit the zoo. Roll it up with my volunteer ship platoon. I'm a big bitch looking for my big baboon. Cross the ocean with my homies, they all think I'm a freak. My devotion to your holiness is hitting the peak. I will only do your bidding till my mission's complete. When I reject humanity and return to Zeke.
Oh!
The more hair, the better. I don't mind you shedding. You feel like a sweater, can I call you daddy?
Please?
I want you to see that I'm not just a laggy. I simp on you more than the viewers hate Gabby.
Oh!
Sirens to Marley, they crash at the rocks. Sometimes I wish that the Titans had come.
Yeah, I think this is some sort of Attack on Titans fan song or something. The video that accompanies this song, it's all clips from Attack on Titan. And if you happen to watch the anime, some of the Titans, the big things, are like monkey creatures, right? They're like monkey Titans.
2 meters tall.
I think that's what they're singing about here.
Guys are afraid, but if I could get with you, then I've got it made. I'm a chimpsin, a monkey sexual. I'm a chimpsin, a monkey sexual. I'm a chimpsin, a monkey sexual. When I met you, then I knew you were something special. I'm a chimpsin. I'm monkey sexual, I'm a chimpsin. I'm monkey sexual, I'm a chimpsin. I'm monkey sexual. Haters stay hated cause I'm so effectual.
At the very least, we have a new theme song jingle for when Pan Panascore calls in. That's something.
Mm-mm, but I'm a Titan junkie. Find me simping for your brother.
Oh!
Ever since they heard, I got my eyes on Eden. Everybody knows that I'm quite a yondetta.
Okay, look, I can't with this. This is too dorky even for me. But there you go. That's Chip Simp Monkey Sexual for your Wednesday. And with that, let's get into the crazy bizarre twist to the fucked up news right now. Storeview Daily is supported by you freaks. If you like DV and you want to hear it continue, consider supporting the show. Best way to do it is to sign up for the sideshow. That is our member site. Every week, I do brand new exclusive shows just for paying freaks. Yesterday was a sideshow exclusive podcast, and I'll be doing another one tomorrow. If you want to hear it, you got to sign up. SuperFreakSideshow.com. Membership's very inexpensive, only $6.99 a month. Even less when you opt for a quarterly, semi-annual, yearly, or lifetime membership. When you sign up through the website, you get access to a personalized, password-protected RSS feed. It works with most, not all podcasting apps, but like Apple Podcasts, Overcast, Podcast Addict, you know, the big ones. Plus, of course, you can listen to the episodes right on the website. Now, if you happen to use Apple Podcasts or Spotify, you can sign up for Sideshow Access right in those apps, and you'll get the Sideshow exclusive episodes right alongside the free episodes. You don't have to mess around with websites or RSS feeds or anything like that. So you can sign up right in those apps. Just a few taps if you happen to use Spotify or Apple Podcasts. Again, for more information, check out distortedview.com or superfreaksideshow.com. And finally, we've got a Patreon account, patreon.com/distortedview. If you just want to support DV, you can throw a few bucks my way. You can pledge as little as a dollar over there. If you pledge $5, you get access to a special voicemail line where I will play your calls first. And we even have higher tiers if you pledge at least $20. Occasionally, I send out DV merchandise and little gifts and stuff to you. This month is going to be one of those months where, higher tiered patrons get a little something in the mail. Working on sending those out this week. So it's a great time to sign up. Patreon.com/distortedview. Okay, three very quick stories now. First up, I highly suggest you check out the chapter artwork if you're able to. If not, go to distortedview.com or superfreaksideshow.com. I will make this today's featured image. What are you looking at? Well, I think the headline to this story reveals all. Man dressed as 7-foot penis is arrested for, you guessed it, harassing women. I mean, it's just something you do when you're a giant 7-foot penis. I don't even blame the guy. It's like you climb into a big cock, that cock is going to take you over, you know? A man dressed as a giant 7-foot penis has been arrested by police after women complained that he had been harassing them. Military police in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, arrested the man dressed as the giant phallus in the city center on Sunday for, quote, acting suspiciously. Hard not to act suspicious when you're in that getup. A picture of the arrest shows the man wearing an inflatable manhood costume. I want to know where you get those things. And a pair of flip-flops. Well, that kind of makes sense, you know, for the outfit. It would be way funnier if he was wearing dress shoes. Or better yet, like high heels. Big fuck me pumps. Really confused people. Yes, a picture of the arrest shows the man wearing an inflatable manhood costume and a pair of flip-flops being led away peacefully by an officer. Just the man's feet and rather glum face can be seen as the officer, with a baton tucked under his arm, takes him into custody. What do they call that festival in Brazil? Carnival? I think that's happening right now. And maybe he just got lost. Women told police that he had been using his costume to chase ladies taking part in the city's parades. Some people online commented that his costume, you know, it's a very dark brown penis. They said that he looks more like shit than a cock. Carnival parades returned to Brazil last weekend for the festival's first full-on edition since the COVID-19 pandemic. See, there's just like a lot of pent-up excitement and energy. That's why people are acting out. The festival was canceled back in 2021 because of the pandemic, which devastatingly swept across the country and claimed up to 700,000 lives. A reduced version of the festival was held last year, which meant the massive street parties known as blocos were banned. Rio de Janeiro has been the home to the parade since the 1980s and is a symbol of Brazil's carnival festivities. Now, again, you know, you may vilify this guy for dressing up like a penis and harassing women, but it's just what happens during that festival. Check this out. Nearly half of Brazilian women who celebrated carnival said they were victims of some sort of sexual harassment during the celebration. At least, you know, this guy did it with a little flair. He dressed up for the party. He's given his sexual harassment 110%. So you got to give him a little credit there, right? All right, second story we have for you. Well, this is one of those stories that could very easily be bullshit. Because first of all, it's not really news. Second of all, it's just like some woman's story. But okay, it's DV worthy, so I'm going to read it. And it was published by a news organization. I'm using news in quotes there. A wedding makeup artist left listeners floored after revealing her client found her groom being breastfed by his mother just moments before the wedding. Even though I'm a little suspicious of this news story, it is possible. We have featured adult titty drinkers before on the podcast. Some, you know, guys never lose the taste for that sweet, sweet booby juice. Georgie Mitchell is the host of the Unfiltered Bride podcast. I can't think of something I would like to listen to less. Every episode, it's just all about weddings and brides, their special day, describing dresses, venues. Oh, I mean, come on. All right. Georgie Mitchell, the host of the Unfiltered Bride podcast, is a professional UK wedding planner and often opens up about wild stories from her time in the industry. Okay, that sounds a little interesting. In the latest episode, she recounted a story she heard from a former coworker, not even her story, total hearsay, right, about a wedding nightmare. Using the pseudonym Jenny to refer to her friend, Georgie explained how the makeup artist had just finished the bride's face and hair when she said she needed to go to the toilet. I gotta take a shit real bad. What the bride saw when she got there was, quote, enough to end the wedding. At first, Georgie's co-host, Beth of Etiquette Events Styling, little plug for that business, assumed that the groom was cheating on his bride with another woman. But it turned out to be so much worse, as the groom was being breastfed by his mother. Maybe it's some sort of religious tradition. You know, the mother is getting ready to let go of her son. This is just like one last parting tit suckle. I mean, there's no way that breast produced milk, right? This is a grown man getting married. His mom's got to be like, what, 70, 80? He's sucking down chalk is what he's doing. There's no way that milk is anything but powdered. Turns out the groom was being breastfed by his mother. Stunned, the co-host Beth replied, I'm sorry, what? Why would you marry a man who still breastfeeds? Georgie jumped to defend the bride, adding, I don't think she knew that this was happening. Beth pondered how the mother was still producing milk. Thank you. But Georgie revealed she's obviously been doing it continuously to get to that point. That was my one thought. Like, if this was a thing, like a common thing, I think the body will just continue producing milk. Right when everyone thought the story couldn't get any more shocking, the bride still went ahead with the wedding. We will talk about this later. Everyone is already here. I give the bride a lot of credit when you think about it. It's true. Like, all these people got dressed up, made the effort to come to the wedding. You know, the reception, all the food, everything's paid for. Just go through with it. You can always get divorced later. Plus, you know, you're going to get all those wedding gifts? I'd go through with the marriage. The story has amassed over 730,000 views as horrified fans flocked to the comments to give their opinion. One user wrote, took mommy's boy to a whole new level. Good one. Another added, the strongest man couldn't lift my jaw right now. A third commented, oh my God, I didn't know what to expect, but that was not even a fleeting thought. And finally, I was like, nothing could be worse than him cheating, but yep, that's worse. I would be a runaway bride so damn fast. What do you think, freaks? Real story or bullshit? I'm leaning towards bullshit. But hey, it got him 750,000 views. Good for them. Finally, today, freaks, do you guys remember many years ago we featured Evil Elmo on the podcast? He was this guy who rented a like Elmo costume in New York City and would just say horrible things to children. Stuff like...
Elmo says Hindus rape children.
Hindus rape children.
Elmo says Hindus rape children. Elmo says Hindus rape children. And remember, you heard this in front of Toys R Us.
That's how long ago Evil Elmo was around. Toys R Us was still a thing. It's not just Hindus that's pissing Elmo off.
That's why I want people to read about the international Jew, because if you start your own business in this city, Jews will harass you. Read about the international...
Elmo is a businessman, you see, and he can't run his business because of the Jews. The Jews are keeping Elmo down.
That is the scariest Elmo I've ever seen in my life.
Well, after a hiatus, I'm happy to report Evil Elmo is back, baby! Hide your kids, hide your wife, you know. Families were out enjoying Monday's sunny weather when police... This, by the way, this is in Santa Cruz, so Evil Elmo has moved from New York City to California. Looking for those sunny days, sweeping the clouds away. On my way to where the Jews don't control the media. Good luck finding that utopia. Sure as hell not in California. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Families were out enjoying Monday's sunny weather when police received reports that a googly-eyed cookie monster was harassing and yelling at people on the Santa Cruz wharf. Is this just an Evil Elmo copycat? No, it's really Evil Elmo. Same dude, different costume. A man dressed up as the furry blue character from the children's show Sesame Street and has sporadically appeared on the wharf by the Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk in recent weeks. The costume-clad man was identified by the Santa Cruz police as Adam Sandler. Not that Adam Sandler. No relation to the real actor. Sandler, 59, reportedly hustles parents for money by seeking out children in tourist areas who want their photographs snapped with Cookie Monster. Quote, we're getting calls from people who say he's creepy. Based on his history, we advise the public not to engage with this individual. Steer clear from him. That's according to the police spokeswoman, Joyce Blaschk. Sandler has a checkered past, according to police and past media reports. In the mid-2010s, Sandler dressed up as Elmo in San Francisco. He earned the nickname Evil Elmo for yelling at tourists who took his photograph without paying tips and for conflicts with small business owners. He was eventually arrested and banned from San Francisco's Fisherman's Wharf. Back in 2015, the local news caught up with him, and Sandler said he believes he was a victim of a harassment campaign launched against him. I didn't do nothing wrong. I'm just trying to entertain the kids. I've got a clip here from that 2015 interview. This is pretty interesting.
Tell me about camp rape.
I'm sorry, did you say camp rape? Evil Elmo knows something about camp rape. This is the same guy taking pictures with your kids out on Times Square and Fisherman's Wharf. What's worse, this dude or those drag queens reading stories at the library to your kids?
Tell me about camp rape.
Oh, it's a wonderful website.
Camp.
Okay, tell me about rape camp.
In 1999, I did an adult entertainment site in Cambodia. I wanted to start an outsourcing company that would develop educational media content, and I needed a cash flow. And I thought I was giving opportunities to women who found no other way to make a living but being prostitutes.
You're listening to Evil Elmo, but his real name is, get this.
Hey, when you describe rape camp, can you do it in the Elmo voice at least? That would be great. Later in the interview, he said, I don't have any psychological problems whatsoever. Glad we got to the bottom of that. In Los Angeles, he was dubbed a serial troublemaker. A business owner there said that Sandler screamed at him and made threats. I don't think he belongs out on the streets. No one wants to hear the Cookie Monster say he's going to kill their family. That's wrong. I want to hear that. Rumors spread around Santa Cruz that the Cookie Monster may be a registered sex offender. That tracks. His name, however, does not appear on the California Megan's Law website. He just forces Cambodian prostitutes to do cam whore work. Nothing wrong with that. So yeah, even though Sandler was once in NYC, he is now in California. He doesn't seem to be anchored down to any one location. He's transient and travels in his van between California cities. Witnesses first began reporting Cookie Monster sightings around the Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk and Wharf in late January. Being creepy in public is not a crime, and so far Sandler has not committed a crime in the city of Santa Cruz, the police said. When asked if it's safe for children to take photos with the Cookie Monster, Blaschke said, "I would not take a photo with him." A spokesperson for the Santa Cruz Wharf issued a public service announcement about him on Wednesday. In recent weeks, you may have seen a man dressed up like the Cookie Monster. It's important to note he is not employed by, contracted by, or permitted by the city of Santa Cruz or any local business. He is exercising his First Amendment rights. If you have concerns about inappropriate behavior or him claiming to be hired by the city, you should contact Santa Cruz police immediately. So there you go. Evil Elmo is back, and he's brought a friend. Nom, 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 nom. That's the sound of Jews taking all your money. Nom, 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 nom. They devour it like Cookie Monster devours cookies. C is for cookie. You know what else C is for? Concentration camps. Learn your Jewish history, you fucking anti-Semite. Bad Cookie Monster. That, my friends, is your distorted news for Wednesday, late Wednesday. Let's do a couple voicemails and get the hell out of here. Love to hear from you, freaks. And there are many ways to contact the show. Show at distortedview.com. I'm all over social media at distortedview on Twitter and Instagram. Facebook.com/distortedview show, yada, yada, yada. All right, let's just do a couple real quick voicemails and call it a day. I want to get this show posted, get back on track, you know.
Hey, listen, so this has been stuck in my head since Monday. It goes, ba-da-ba-ba-ba, yeah!
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Thank you. I sounded like a dick.
You always do.
Saying the hard R word and the N word, I apologize.
Unicorn Hamster let the N word fly on yesterday's Sideshow exclusive podcast.
I just, maybe your listeners don't know I'm as hood as chili cheese Fritos.
Oh, I'm sure that provides a great comfort to black listeners hearing that podcast. Oh, Unicorn Hamster's hood. Okay. It's okay, yes, then. Man. Let that N-word fly, my friend. It's okay. You don't know his story. You know, he may have received the N-word card from an African-American.
Hey, Tim. Haley's Comet calling up to let you know that your choice of best of episode may have turned out to be very fortuitous.
Oh.
In it, there's a clip of Gordon Manning, and he's...
Well, it's Pastor James Manning, not Gordon Manning, but okay.
In it, there's a clip of Gordon Manning, and he's ranting about Trump, and ranting about JFK Jr.'s nephew, and ranting about Herman Cain. And it occurs to me, since that episode aired, since Manning recorded that, Herman Cain went on to die of COVID...
True.
After having contracted it at a Trump rally. Now, we know Gordon Manning loves to gloat about everything. So, we may be on the track now of finding the best Gordon Manning gloat of all time.
He's really doubling down on that whole Gordon Manning thing, huh?
We need to find everything he and his church released in the weeks and months after Herman Cain's death and give it a listen. Because somewhere in there, I'm confident... there's going to be an epic Reverend Manning rant.
All right. Well, there you go, freaks. Haley's Comet. I don't know exactly what Haley's Comet is saying here, but something to do with Herman Cain. We need to find Herman Cain-related clips on the Pastor Manning Show.
Hello, Timothy Henson. This is Jacoby Shaddix, lead singer of Papa Roach. I'm a big fan, by the way.
This is Pan Panascore, isn't it? Isn't this his voice?
Henson. This is Jacoby Shaddix, lead singer of Papa Roach. I'm a big fan, by the way. But unfortunately, I'm calling today in an official capacity as a member of the FBI's Blue Panel Committee on 90s Preservation to serve you with a fine of $12,000 for violating Statute 1999,
oh, no.
Which is known as the Required Lyrical Allusion Statute. On January 24th, 2023, in a show, when describing the incel phenomenon of transmaxing, you ended a sentence saying, and I quote, that losers considered gender transition as a last resort. Unfortunately, you failed to continue suffocation, no breathing. Don't give a fuck if I cut my arm bleeding. Yes, that was a mistake. As this is your first offense, you can mail your payment to us within 3 weeks at the tent on the corner of 96th and 24th Avenue, care of Mark McGrath, Los Angeles, California, 90024. By the way, Toad the Wet Sprocket is here. They're very disappointed and beg you to be more mindful in the future. Thank you for your cooperation.
Okay, well, give Sister Hazel my best. My mind doesn't go right to Papa Roach lyrics like they do, you know, Toad the Wet Sprocket or the Gin Blossoms. So, yes, when I said this is my last resort, I wasn't thinking that it's from a Papa Roach song. I believe the line before that is cut my life into pieces, which in a way does sort of describe gender reassignment surgery, right? They're getting all cut. They're cutting up their life and rearranging things. That could be a trans anthem, really. Could breathe new life into Papa Roach. All right. Well, there you go. Thank you very much, lead singer of Papa Roach. That's all the time we have on this edition of the show. I want you guys to email me, show@distortedview.com. Distortedview.com is our official website. Voicemail line for you, 206-666-4463. That's 206-66. Oh, God. Is it? Oh, God.
Had a few sips of my own urine.
Spread the distortion. STD. Tell all your friends about the show. Don't forget to give us a 5-star rating, a thumbs up, or like wherever you can rate it. Review podcasts. I will be back on Thursday for a Sideshow exclusive episode. Otherwise, I'll see you back on Friday. Until then, have a great day. Bye, everybody!
I'm not gonna fight for my country. I just wanna smoke my weed, man.
This has been another excellent podcast from the Scribe Media Group. Learn more at scribe.net.